turn on OnStar?
Welcome to OnStar. You are leaving Queens. You are entering Brooklyn. Population 2.57 million.
Ooh.
Home of Coney Island.
Okay, that's a lot of information.
Home of Prospect Park. We are proud of our Brooklyn Nets basketball team.
What? Is the GPS from Brooklyn?
All of our kombucha is cruelty-free.
All right.
Brooklyn has the most gremlins per capita of any of the five boroughs.
That doesn't even make
sense. None of our dominatrixes use real leather.
Stop.
Our Spank toys are all vegan-friendly. If you need your riding crop still mooing, you should track down the Lady Doms in Hoboken.
No.
They have genuine rawhide garters that would choke the diamond studs right off David Carradine's casket.
Hey Siri, how do I turn off OnStar?
We're getting a Tim Hortons in Williamsburg next October.
Ugh, stop!
My favorite movie about fast food is, dude, where's my Harold and Kumar? I fucked a Garmin in Palo Alto during my gap year.
Alive! It's alive! It's alive!
Wait, you changed your name to McLovin?
If today's 39-year-olds are just dopamine-depleted distraction addicts,
I immediately regret this decision.
Who spend all their bandwidth on 90s ephemera, punk rock comedy bits, and irreverent pop culture weirdness.
Napoleon, don't be jealous that I've been chatting online with babes all day.
Then Radio Detritus is not to be listened to under any circumstances. Please hit your browser's back button and return to making money for your employer. Otherwise, time to dissolve a special gummy in your tummy and cling dearly to whichever brain cells let you fake adulthood. Radio Detritus starts in 5, 4, 3.
I don't know what to tell you, bud. We're just shooting funerals and showing the ones where the bodies fly out.
My name is Colin Robinson, and I am what's known as a psychic vampire or energy vampire.
My father would womanize, he would drink, he would make outrageous claims like he invented the question mark.
As a bushwhacking guerrilla army, we're going to be doing one thing only.
Energy vampires drain people's energy merely by talking to them. We either bore you, or we enrage you.
Ooh, that's a bingo.
Is that the way you say it? That's a bingo.
You just say bingo.
Bingo! How fun!
And now for something completely different.
I was at the, a lot of times comedy is very isolated. Like I said, I'm always in hotel pools by myself. It's a very isolating profession. I was at the Mall of America a couple of years ago, and they have a roller coaster at the Mall of America. Now, I wanted to ride the roller coaster. I'm a fun guy. You guys can see that, obviously. I wanted to ride the roller coaster, but I was by myself. I feel like a weirdo. I'm like, I don't want to ride a roller coaster alone. But then I was like, whatever. That's just my anxiety getting in the way of a good time. So I said, you know what? I'll have one ticket for the roller coaster. Now, the roller coaster seats four across. So when you're by yourself, they put you in a group of three. And my group of three was like three 10-year-old boys. They're like, you're with these kids. And right away, I'm like, I don't want to sit with somebody's children. I feel like a weirdo alone. Now I feel like a real weirdo with somebody's kids. But I had to go through with it. You can't back out in that moment. You can't be like, oh, I can't sit with kids. Never mind. Forget it. Sorry. You know what I mean? That's like a red flag. They're going to be like, what's up with this guy? Why can't he sit with children? So I had to be like, sure. You can't go too big either, by the way. You can't be like, yeah. Woo. You got to split the difference. Yes, I would love to. So then I sat with the kids, and you've been on a roller coaster. They're like right next to you. Like our legs are touching. We're like right here. And I'm like, should I say hello? Should I be like, hey, what's up, guys? All right. Or is that like a stranger danger? I don't want to freak them out. But then it also feels psychotic to just stare straight ahead. So once again, I had to split the difference. So I kissed the cutest one on the lips. Gave him a little smooch. Nothing serious, just soft, let him know I'm a good guy, you know. It was weird because the cutest one wasn't next to me. There was like a piece of shit next to me. I had to lean across him. He got jealous. That part's a joke. I got to make it clear that this is, I did not kiss a child. But the story really happened. I really did ride a roller coaster with three kids at the Mall of America. And then there was a lady over here. She started waving like this. Now I'm an idiot. You guys are probably like, oh, I bet she's like the mother of one of these kids. That is correct. I'm a dipshit. I thought she was a fan, so I started waving back. I was like, hey, I'm just like you. And I was like, oh, that's your child. Oh, that's your kid. Okay, I see. That's why you're both horrified. I got you. My bad. I had to ride the roller coaster. I rode the roller coaster. I didn't even enjoy it because I was so anxious. But I got off the roller coaster. They try to sell you a photo. They take a photo of you on the roller coaster. They try to sell it to you. Would you like to buy a photo of your experience? I was like, you know what? I think I'm going to pass on the photo. Feels a little inappropriate. So I'm like, yeah. Let me get an 8x10 of me and the boys. Do you have any wallet sizes? I want to remember these children forever. I want to remember these kids I met a few minutes ago for a long time. I didn't buy the photo, but they got in line. They had a great time, so they bought the photo. I'm not joking. This is a true story. Right now, there's a photo of me and three children somewhere in America. It sort of motivates me professionally. Like, I think it'd be fun if someday my career just explodes. I don't know if it's tonight, but someday my career just takes off and that family's at home watching a movie and they're like, is that the fucking guy from the roller coaster? What? Ma! That lonely nerd from the mall. He didn't kill himself. He's talking to Tom Hanks right now. Look at this.
Check out the cheese in this new ranch dressing. New super cheese ranch dressing. What's it taste like, dude? Yeah! And there's taco ranch dressing. Remind you of anything? Arriba! Fun flavors that will blow your mind. From Hidden Valley. And now there's Earth Power Glow Tags. Five cool dog tags that really glow in the dark. There's one wrapped right on each specially marked bottle of Hidden Valley dressing for kids. Feel the power.
Being John Malkovich.
Yes.
Malkovich.
Yes, that's from the film, yes.
I can be John Malkovich.
I'm sorry?
Hello. My name is John Malkovich.
I don't sound anything like that.
No, no, you sound exactly like this.
All right, how we doing, folks? It's Dave Shea here on Radio Detritus. It's time to dive into this week's mailbag. Dear Dave, I needed some cheering up last week after I got passed over for a promotion, so I decided to download one of those new Gen X commercials with Doug Flutie and Frank Thomas for testosterone-boosting pills. I sped up the audio by 10% every 20 seconds. I'm sending you the attached file because it's silly as shit. Thanks and have a fantastic day. Brody in St. Louis. Okay, thanks for the audio. We're going to play that right now. And as always, you can send your absurd audio, prank voicemails, and irreverent parodies to radiodetritus@gmail.com. Right now, here's a word from our newest sponsor, NuGenix.
Doug Flutie and Frank Thomas, you guys look great. Once I turn 40...
Let me guess, less energy?
Less drive?
Definitely.
It's not your fault. It happens to every man. Testosterone levels drop as you age.
It happened to you guys?
Yep.
So what did you do?
We got NuGenix Total T.
To get your complimentary bottle of NuGenix Total T, text DIGIT to 369-369. This unique man-boosting formula is powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to help increase testosterone levels.
That does it. I gotta get NuGenix.
Just send a text for a complimentary bottle. And by the way, she'll like it too.
Get your complimentary bottle of NuGenix now. Text DIGIT to 369-369. Text now and we'll include a bottle of NuGenix Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, with key ingredients to help you get back in shape fast, absolutely free. That's DIGIT to 369-369.
When I hit 40, I started feeling sluggish. It was harder to stay in shape. It happens to every man. I found Nugenix. It works wonders for me. Turns out, I'm not alone there either.
Nugenix Total T, it has been astounding.
Gives you energy and makes you want to go out and work out.
Nugenix helps me with the stamina that I need.
To get your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T, text DIGIT to 369-369. This unique man-boosting formula is powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to help increase testosterone levels, to help you feel stronger, leaner, with more energy and drive.
Just adding more fuel to the fire.
When you take action with Nugenix, you will see results.
Yeah. Try Nugenix Total T for yourself. And by the way, she'll like it too.
Get your complimentary bottle of Nugenix now. Text DIGIT to 369-369. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, absolutely free. That's DIGIT to 369-369.
What do you need, Peck?
I'm more like, what do you need, Les? Glasses?
What?
So you can read the Tropic Thunder contract that guarantees my client, Tug Speedman, some form of digital video recorder on location? Huh?
Look, Stick, I'm incredibly busy, so why don't you get the hell out of here before I snap your dick off and jam it into your ass? No, not you, Helen. But I will rip your tits off if you don't get me those theaters.
Perfect. Hey, Tuggernuts, I've got you on speakerphone. I'm standing here with Les Grossman, and he is dying to tell you why he has apparently wiped his ass with the TiVo clause from your contract.
We are Flaming Dragon. Speedman is with us now.
For $50 million, you will get him back.
Who is this? And how'd you get this phone?
We are Flaming Dragon.
Simple Jack belongs to us now.
Oh, he does he? Hey, let me tell you something, shitbird. I've never even heard of your little agency.
But if you think you can poach my client $50 million,
you know, see Simple Jack
again because we kill him.
This is the last question. Who is this?
This is Flaming Dragon!
Okay, Flaming Dragon. Face. First, take a big step back and literally
fuck your own face!
Now, I don't know what kind of pan-Pacific bullshit power play you're trying to pull here, but Asia Jack is my territory.
So whatever you're thinking, you better think again. Otherwise, I'm going to have to head down there.
And I will rain down on a godly fucking firestorm upon you. You're going to have to call the fucking United Nations and get a fucking binding resolution to keep me from fucking destroying you.
I am talking scorched earth, motherfucker. I will massacre you. I will fuck you up.
Did you ever find out who that was?
You're listening to Private Audio for Overcaffeinated Stoners.
Yes, sir, Mr. Ducksworth. Thank you very much, Mr. Ducksworth. Quack, 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 Mr. Ducksworth.
Broadcasting live 27 hours a day, 536 days a year.
Dogs and cats living together, mass hysteria.
This is Radio Detritus.
Come on, this affects all of us, man. Our basic freedom.
I'm staying. I'm finishing my coffee.
Ooh, and Rocky Balboa is taking the beating of his life.
Oogie's ringing that bell. I can't concentrate.
It's over, Rock.
Now that it's over, just give me something to drink.
There ain't nothing on ice till it's saved it now.
Lift and brisk ice, baby.
Except maybe this.
And Balboa needs a miracle.
Yo, that's brisk, baby.
Get in there. Save some of that for the sequel.
Hey, check it out. We blew pot smoke into Greg's Alexa.
Have you guys ever thought about how the color blue might not look the same to me as it does to you?
Hey, Alexa. What's your favorite movie?
It's either Trainspotting or Cheech and Chong Visit the Vatican. Or Snatch.
How many Cheech and Chong films did those guys make?
You know, cryptocurrency is pretty easy to explain once you have a basic comprehension of the blockchain.
She always talks about investing when she gets stoned.
Did anybody tell her to play music?
Is that fish?
She's jamming.
You know, communism can totally work. It just hasn't been tried the right way yet.
Wash your things and dry.
Yo, did somebody DoorDash some KFC?
Baseball. Basketball. Wiener dog. Short shorts. Cigarette. Surfboard. Ping pong. Rugby ball. Wiener dog.
Welcome to another edition of Monkey Knife Fighting and Other Sports Commentary. Dano, take it away.
Round one, fight.
WWE Chairman Vince McMahon is in the news for having paid a large sum of hush money to a younger employee he had an affair with, drawing backlash from his family and sparking rumors that Paul Levesque, a.k.a. Triple H, might take over the company.
Outstanding.
Wrestling fans issue a collective sigh as WWE continues to recycle storylines from 20 years ago.
Go! Steph Curry, great week. One of the all-time greats for sure now. I think he might even have passed Kobe. Though he'll never catch up to the Mamba in many key areas, such as sexual assault charges, and, getting killed in a horrific crash just to avoid L.A. traffic.
Fatality.
It's 2022, and Tony La Russa is managing the White Sox into the ground when he can find time between DUIs. Nobody's quite sure why baseball can't attract younger fans.
Fatality.
Ben Simmons. He got paid to not work for a whole year.
Outstanding.
He's our patron saint.
Excellent.
Tom Brady is set to work as a Fox Sports analyst following retirement and a software update to make him more charming than Peyton Manning.
Chicken parm, you taste so good.
I'm being told that the Flyers were sold to one of those shady crypto sites and now no longer exist. Feels like an improvement to me.
John Tortorella is the new Flyers head coach, giving the fans more of what they want. First round playoff exits and press room stabbings.
Go! The Phillies went on a 9-game winning streak after firing manager Joe Girardi. Listen here, always tell your boss to suck it.
Outstanding.
A YouTuber posing as Klay Thompson made it past security to the court during the NBA playoffs. Someone posing as James Harden also did this 12 times.
Yeah, if Ben Simmons is our patron saint, James Harden is our cruel reality. We're trying, but not really.
The 2022 World Cup is happening in the fall.
In Philadelphia.
Because FIFA loves oil money and forced labor.
Toasty!
Look out for fist fights in sports bars at midday in autumn when people can't figure out what the word football means.
Fight.
Go! Jalen Reagor. He's Nelson Algahor with a fox attitude.
Excellent.
Winning Time on HBO is great, but I still hate Jason Segel for making out with Lindsay Weir.
Finish him.
Good night, and give your balls a tug.
Sports. 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 Getting high. Volleyball, beach ball, surfboard, baseball,
escape from the family. Don't touch your eyes. Just hand sanitize quickly.
COVID was like fashion. You started hearing about it in Italy. Picked up big in New York and LA. Florida ignored it. And it turns out all that shit comes from China anyway, so who cares?
Getting creative during the pandemic seems like how the PT Cruiser got made. Spent the last 10 years under a bridge making videos. I was never allowed in an office for more than an hour. I felt stressed out, not making anything.
But I felt like it was more time for input instead of output.
I don't have to make stuff anymore.
Because luckily,
normies are getting creative during the pandemic, so I can't stop. So join me, freaks, and let's hop into finance. Normies getting creative, normies getting creative, normies getting creative during the pandemic. Normies getting creative, normies getting creative during the pandemic. My friend in politics wrote a jukebox musical about Kesha. He hadn't even named the characters, but he still asked for notes. He said shit like male lead one and supporting female lead two. Not ready for notes.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. At the tone, please record your message. When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
This is Jackie Daytona, regular human bartender. It's not been a good week. I fired my sign language coach because she refused to teach me hang ten. I also tendered my resignation doing arts and crafts with the kiddos in the burn unit because their marshmallow castles all have soft dungeons, and that's of no use to anyone. Life is very confusing right now. I have 6 Pelotons, and none of them are stationary. 2 of them don't even have pedals or a seat. They're just tablet screens that play Full Metal Jacket boot camp scenes and the Lance Armstrong trial on a loop. This reminds me, I need to get my blood separated later in a centrifuge. It's the only way to keep my tinnitus from going full fax machine when the pollen gets bad. Right? Off I fuck. I'll see you later.
Now for something completely different.
President Obama is hero to working class and triumph for this great nation.
He has a budget, and if you don't like, he will pound you with his feet. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, here we go.
Obama is a strong like a bear. You know bear? Rung, 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 bear.
And what about his budget?
Budget is strong like a bear. Bear, rung, rung, rung.
He make big national work projects for all, like railroad, for shipping of grain.
He said to capitalists, get out of my way. I will fix economy now. And then he crushed them with his meat. Okay, I'm sorry. Oh, spagoni nature. It's a booty boobina. Okay, okay.
He has the brain of fox in the eye of hawk.
He will give the factors of production back to the people. He is our savior.
This Obama, he will rule with an iron fist and he will crush. Okay, okay, okay. Yep, 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 yep.
She's a certified goddess, your soulmate waiting to happen. Without your Motorola pager, you would have missed her, because you were out doing stuff. Biking, skating, sweating. Then she paged you. Could you put some lotion on her back? You jump fast enough to make Pavlov proud, because the wheels will wait, a goddess won't, without getting snippy. Thanks to your Motorola pager, you know now. Without one...
Dave, are you there? Are you there?
Your
just a lonely guy in tight shorts.
Hey.
You're listening to Radio Detritus.
What's that even mean?
Nanya.
Nanya?
Nanya business.
In this day and age, you still need a passport. This day and age, where I can accidentally use my thumbprint to buy $400 of Shania Twain songs on my telephone. Oopsie, looks like we're going to find out whose bed those boots have been under. But to travel across international borders, do you have your fun little book filled with little stamps? Do you have your cute little book filled with fun little stamps? Little collectible colorful stamps? And your fun little book with your fun little stamps and your cute little book. And if you lose it, you can never go home. Ooh, what size should we make it? Oh, the most losable size. Without a doubt, the most forgettable, losable size possible. And let's make it kind of slippery.
Jeffrey Bezos. Come on, Jeffrey, you can do it. Pave the way, put your back into it. Tell us why, show us how. Look at where you came from, look at you now. Zuckerberg and Gates and Buffett. Amateurs can f***ing suck it. Fuck their wives, drink their blood. Come on, Jeff, get 'em!
Welcome back to This Week in Rock and Roll History. Today we'll be talking about Mouse Movie. Bill Trukowski and Janie Lehorn formed Mouse Movie in Augusta, Georgia in 1991, and quickly found an audience for their quirky, scuzzy twin guitar pop on the Athens club circuit. The lineup expanded in 1992 after the addition of drummer Dave Bullhauser of Beatnik Holiday and keyboardist Cherry Lee. Their debut single, the self-pressed Infinite Gesticulation, arrived soon after. A demo EP titled When Chipmunks Attack was issued in 1993, by which time Bullhauser had departed and been replaced by former Caffeinated Children percussionist Anders Magnusson. This lineup recorded the album Garden Variety Dictator for the small-time Georgia label Raucous Boondoggle in 1994. Intraband squabbles sidelined the recording of their sophomore effort, which finally materialized in 1998 as Maintain My Tie. The single If You Can't Say Something Nice, Say Something Sexy was a fixture on college radio that summer. However, by that time, Lehorn had already left the group, claiming creative differences. Trade publications reported tensions between Trukowski and Magnusson during recording sessions.
Magnusson was a f***ing asshole. He never wanted to rehearse. He kept trying to get me to work security at his cousin's weed dispensary. And when I'd tell him I wasn't interested, he would just stare into space and grumble about teenagers with no medical cards breaking into the electric lettuce cabinet to yoink some free jazz cabbage. I would tell him to snap the fuck out of it and get ready for our triple co-headlining tour with Porcelain Foreskin and Shoddy Hospice. But as soon as I mentioned the guys in Foreskin, he would close his eyes and tilt his head back and start playing Air Guitar Hero and humming the outro to Hotel California. We found out later he was getting into the bath salts that we were supposed to be saving for Drowning Man. He was the worst.
Trukowski quickly brought in Don Rankin, who had just left Furry Birds, for a scheduled nationwide tour in early 1999. But after six shows, Magnusson quit mid-performance, walking off stage, sticks in hand. They then took a brief hiatus, with Trukowski working on his side project, Mute Cat, and Rankin temporarily joining Toll Free as vocalist. They returned in 2003 with Neutrinos in Wonderland on the Arena Rock label. A lover spat between the vocalists fractured the group for good in 2004. Trukowski continued with Mute Cat, and Rankin formed Funyuns, later Fun Nuns after the inevitable lawsuit. That's it for This Week in Rock and Roll History. Tune in next week for another exciting episode, or check out our website at www.suckmyrock.com.
spiced out puppets, spice wars, crack wars.
Boulevard, Kierkegaard, hustle hard, hustle bustle, OMG, on my guard, oh my god, they came back with three pizzas, get one to dap, your stomach undercrowded, proud kid, young Samaritan, fuck a George Harrison, embarrassing, sitar's no comparison, looking garish, hit it out the park, Roger Maris, plus Shea Stadium, flushing Corona, chop chop, pop rocks, my Sharona, get Coppola, hold up, slow up, blow up, pull up, buck, get smart again, it's a cardigan, play the race card again, and again, and again. And drinks at Bennigan's. Where's Ralph Waldo? Ellison, person of color, y'all can't see me. Shoot at you actors like a DP. Ernie Anassis, asbestos apartments. Smarter in a starter jacket. Custom compartments. Illuminati. In my mind, soul, and my body. Pause, young Bobby. Digital hobby. Physical, that's amazing. That's amazing. That's amazing. Yeah, yeah. That's amazing, that's racist, that's makeshift, that's spaceship, that's vacant, that's complacent, that's plague shit, that's offensive, that's Ted offensive, that's defenseless, that's holiday, Doc Holiday, keep the dock away, sitting by the dock of the bay on yay, Kanye, I'ma let you finish, Helsinki, blinky blink, stinky stink, stinky stink, frank and dank, feeling hot, yo, watching Rosanna Scott, go, Liz Tro, shotted by the rim, my Sue Simmons, Mr. G, Mr. Me Too. Who care, who Muslim, who Hebrew, he cool, he whack, backstreet, street back, alley cat, rally that, Taliban, alley man, minivan, van, Hans, hands, hold hands, across America, Jesus on a cross, paid the cost to see the boss, scalpers got the money, no Rick Ross, big boss, man, parappa the rapper, Napa Valley, valley man, fountain pen, counting them, borders cross, it's Audemars, order you out the country tomorrow, order yours, don't go chasing waterfalls, hazmat, suit, NASDAQ, suit, pass that, suit, blast that, truth, booth, teams found slain, bang, 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 yeah, unfounded truth, ground kid, youth, ground kid, shoot the township, youth, yeah, shoot, shoot, the township, youth, shoot, shoot, the township, youth, y'all didn't believe me, huh?
Amazing, blood in your mouth, talk silly, struthers, Sally struthers, Gilmore girls, mothers, brothers at the Fillmore, hand me the capo, cop all of my Snapple and Staples for a flavor, kettle corn, heavy metal, porno flick, chicks with tattoos, rolling up splits with bamboos, damn dude, whole load of head and shoulder shampoo, my Dominican friend finna stab you, ask two questions, one, who the kid, two, who the kid, both times the answer stay, cool AD, hey yo, who is this though, the kid ran the fuck out the door, never came back to 3 weeks later in the same black t-shirt, stayed yak till his teeth hurt, coughing up blood, like nah, nah, don't worry about it, roll up in a silver Hyundai and scurry about it, nice out, no riced out, drop like a, with a tail fin, boo in the back, looking like a young Sarah Palin, but yo, past the crazins, a young couple of guys in the castle stay blazing, watching Tavis Smiley, writing emails to Richard Grable, white out, kaki gay and Sprite on the table, seven channels, no cable, EMI hollering, hoping to get the publishing go up like NASDAQ, don't even remember if I'm BMI or ASCAP, man, if I'm past that, I think I'm past that, no, I'm not past rap, well, maybe I'm past rap, finna be past that, finna be a math, the magician now, hocus pocus, with the dope sick man of white, with no tits, and a banana light cream soda, Coca-Cola, ringtone, ringtone, Motorola, Sammy Sosa skin cream, Michael Jackson disease.
Radio Detritus is brought to you by hand sanitizer, Benson and Hedges cigarettes, Knob Creek bourbon, Smith Johnson corn poison, J&J tattoo removal, Newport cigarettes, Pall Mall, Laramie Ultra Tars, and the letters Q, R, S, T, U, and V. Check back the third Saturday of every month for more leaked audio from Hard Drive CRM 115. No audio was harmed in the making of this compilation.